America has never really been ahead of the curve when it comes to sex or allure or even glamour. It's really very conservative, and most of the time has been. It's reflected fashion, and by that fashion I don't just mean the fashion of the clothes that the contestants wear, but it's reflected the fashion of the times and the way people think. It's never been a girly show.
The girly show arrived in 1955. It was called the Miss Universe.
A quarter of $1 million crown awaits Miss Universe as the grand finale of the world's greatest beauty competition begins in Long Beach, California, after months of preliminaries. Entries representing 32 nations, the epitome of beauty in every culture and every clime, pass before critical judges and an enthralled audience.
Miss Universe started essentially because Miss America refused to be sexy enough. Catalina Bathing Suits was the major sponsor of Miss America at that time, and one of the contestants, Yolande Bette-Bees, refused to wear a bathing suit after she won the crown. And the pageant backed her up and said, no, you don't have to. And so Catalina, in a huff and not surprisingly, said, well, if that's the way you're going to treat our product, we're out of here. And so they went out and invented Miss Universe.
I have some photographs of the first ad that was in the newspapers and magazines. And it said, go to your local store, buy a Catalina swimsuit, take your photo in the swimsuit, and you sent the photo into our headquarters. And the people there decided who would be Miss California, Miss New York, or what have you. So that was the initial beginning. You came to Long Beach, beautiful Long Beach, California, is the way they put it.
Lovely Piper Laurie of Hollywood sets the stage at Long Beach, California for the selection of the world beauty who will win a starring contract with Universal International. Miss Laurie introduces the contestants from 30 nations seeking the title of Miss Universe, most beautiful girl in the world.
The prize at that point was you got to come there. You had an opportunity to take a screen test at Universal Studios, and I think you got a watch. That was about the extent of it in those days. It's come a long way since then.
World's most beautiful girls, reaching for the crown that represents the peak of international beauty and prestige. It's all an exciting preview of the competition for the coveted title of
Pinakamagandang Dilag sa Buong Daigdig.
And what does that mean?
Miss Universe.
You know, whoever said beauty is in the eye of the beholder must have had me in mind. Because in the past 16 years, I have beheld most of the world's great beauties hosting the Miss Universe pageant. And we're here to give you a behind-the-scenes look at this spectacular happening. Choosing a new Miss Universe has become an international event viewed by 600 million people in 50 countries via satellite. And if there's one thing I've learned after all those live telecasts, it's that anything can happen. I know one night a girl's strap broke on her evening gown. The evening gown began to fall. I caught the evening gown. I saved that girl. But the cameramen were furious with me. Of course they would be. But I always expect the unexpected during the interviews. And the way I see it, it's not what they say, but the way they say it.
You speak English?
Of course.
Well, speak English. Say something.
Listen to me. Thank you. I'm sorry. I'm very happy to represent my country. I live in Belgrade, and etc., etc.
Unas palabras in English, see?
Yes, I'm very, 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 very little.
What words do you know in English?
hungry.
Hungry?
Help.
Help?
And boys.
Boys? Do you know my name? What is my name?
My name is Sashiko Nakayama.
No, you, Sashiko.
Yes.
Me, Bob. What can you say in English?
I love New York.
Great! What words do you know in English? Tell me one word or two or three.
I need a drink.
What, I need a drink?
Yes.
What can you say in English?
You are the most handsome man.
You have a brilliant young lady here. In Czechoslovakia?
With
microphone talk? Talk? In Czechoslovakia, job? Talk? Television?
Yeah, I speak television.
She speaks television is what? So where have you traveled?
Well, I've been to Trenton, New Jersey. I've been to...
What was the most beautiful state you saw?
Oh, I remember Georgie. What's...
Georgie?
Yes, Georgie. I tell why, but because it was so strange. And you're a famous person, that's obvious, of course. And now let's come down to your affairs, shall we?
My what?
The most interesting part of your life, yes. Your affairs.
My affairs?
Yes.
Yes, that's what
I had to open an old folks home, and I met a very old man. He was 103 years old.
103?
Yes, very old. And he gave me a peck on the cheek, and he said, oh, I wish I was 10 years younger.
And they asked her her favorite television star, you said...
The Price is Right.
As you can see, I haven't changed a bit. It's my tuxedo that's getting older. You know, the Miss Spectacular, since it began in Long Beach, California in 1952, the pageant has grown to be as glamorous as the women in it. It has become bigger and more exciting every year. Another popular feature of the Miss Universe pageant is the Parade of Nations, when each contestant gets to show off her national costume. It's also an important part of the pageant because the girls are judged and scored on how well their costumes look. Some are elaborate, some are simple, and some are just plain strange. They come in all shapes, sizes, and colors. Some of the girls bring their costumes in their purses. Others have to rent a 747. I've seen costumes that are bigger than the countries they represent. But if you think it's hard wearing one of these costumes, try walking behind one. You can lose an eye. He's up against a lot of competition here. You have to remember that this is an international contest, and they're competing for more than $150,000 in prizes, not to mention that year of experience and exposure.
You're right, Bob. Those are some pretty good reasons for beautiful women from all over the world to enter the pageant.
Pageants around the world are as different as the young women in them. Some are contests announced in newspapers, with the winner chosen by write-in votes. Some are run by modeling agencies and look like fashion shows. But all are special events, and the one thing they have in common is that magic moment.
Thing is, when you used to watch a beauty contest on TV, and then you'd prance, you know, along.
Yes.
You were the beauty queen.
Yes, I know exactly what you mean. I used to watch it. My mother started us watching it since we were about 30.
I think every girl dreams of it.
And we all, you know, you think, oh, wouldn't you just love to be out there being one of those girls?
I was asked to enter, and I said no at first because like a lot of other people in Norway, I didn't really like what these contests stand for. But now I heard that the contests in Norway were supposed to be different. But now I know a whole lot more about it, and I think it's totally different.
Contestants is the first of many tough assignments. Getting them to one location from all over the globe is another. Some of the girls have never been out of their own countries and speak only their native languages. Airport arrivals must be coordinated so that each young woman is welcomed personally. Once the contestants arrive, they're in for 3 weeks of fun and excitement, many of them enjoying their first visit to the United States and all it has to offer. But they're also in for 3 weeks of hard work. To put on a pageant this big takes an army of technicians and production personnel, not to mention chaperones, press representatives, drivers, and other volunteers. There are television segments to be taped, dinners to attend, and lots of rehearsals.
I belong to you.